Yeah, I've seen it.
Oh no, Kirby. I could record. We have to start now.
Oh.
Hi, welcome to the first episode of Podcast Pals. It's about pals who make a podcast. Okay, let's start with intros. My name is Donovan. I am the owner of the Poke Pals Discord server. And it's a Discord server that's been around for about 7-8 months-ish. And this is a podcast just about like general gaming stuff going on. And we've been wanting to do it for a while, and now we're finally getting together to do it.
Because we're lazy.
Yeah.
But Donovan, what's your favorite game?
That sounds so fake. Oh my god.
I don't know, Abe, why don't you introduce yourself and I'll say what my favorite game is.
Yeah, introduce yourself first.
Alright, fine.
There's an order to all this.
Okay, shut up. Listen, here. Hi, my name is Abe. I joined PokePals the day it was made. Here's a little lore for you guys. PokePals was made for a YouTube Plays Pokemon Platinum. That was definitely chaotic. Didn't work like that, though. The server then quickly transformed into a Pokemon server, and then it transformed into a hot piece of garbage.
You forgot the part where it became a Nintendo server, and then a hot piece of garbage.
That too.
I'm sorry about that. It's so well, not my fault, by the way. Oh yeah, fuck you. You go.
Who am I? Oh yeah, I'm. Well, hello there. My name is Feki, and I'm a guy who is really shy, and I just joined the PokePals, and it's a really good server. That is not a lie.
It is pretty good, yeah.
Also, please cover me.
All right.
Go ahead.
Hold up. I have my thing prepared, and I'm going on my phone.
You see, I
do my introduction again.
Good luck.
Okay, so, hi, I'm... God. Hi, I'm Eli. I'm the resigning god of the PokePals. I create art and video games and memes. I'm the main person and the only one who makes pretty decent graphic logos for PokePals. I like jazz.
Hey, my graphics are nice too.
Fuck off. Alright, so I like jazz, J-pop, musicals, and a ton of rock. My favorite games are Call of Duty 4, don't hate me, Persona 4, there's a trend with this one, and Pokemon Heart Gold. My favorite color is platinum and purple, and there's one last thing you need to know about me. I'm never gonna give you up!
I wish I could.
Whoa, which one is the new Persona? Is that Persona 5 or 4?
5.
Yeah, it's 5.
Oh, okay. Dancing All Night. Sorry.
No, please.
I like the music from the new one.
Okay. Persona 5, Dancing All Night, or whatever it's called, is a really good game. For music. That's it. The game sucks. It's bad. Trust me.
Persona Q sucks ass. Wait, what?
Abe, favorite video game.
Nani?
Alright.
Oh, God, no!
No. Please remove them.
Alright, favorite video games. Let's do this. My favorite video games. I associate video games with memories more than I do with actual gameplay. My favorite video games are probably Persona 5, Pokemon Sun and Moon, Pokemon Platinum, Smash 4, and I'm currently playing through Xenoblade 2, and it's really got me hooked. Also, Breath of the Wild, shout out.
Shout out to Breath of the Wild.
Breath of the Wild was okay.
Bad game. Wait, what?
You know, we're talking about bad games, let's talk about Doki Doki Literature Club.
Okay, this is where you leave the call.
Okay.
I hate you.
My favorite game? Talked about Call of Duty 4, because, you know, I played on the... Okay, so this is the reason why I played Call of Duty 4, I love Call of Duty 4, because it was on the Wii, and the Wii was like my first console, and, you know, good memories with the Wii and stuff, like, you get to play, like...
Wii Fit?
Wii Fit, Imagine Babies, and then, like, you know, my most favorite game on the Wii ever is Xenoblade.
I thought Xenoblade was... You're gonna get us a copyright strike. I thought Xenoblade was only on the new 3DS.
Oh no.
It was
on like the Wii before, and then it went to the new 3DS.
I don't even know it was on the Wii.
Because they needed a reason to sell the new 3DS. And guess what? It worked, because I bought it.
No, man, I wish I still played, like, all the new 3DS games, you know, because, you know, I wish I had my 3DS.
Donovan, what are your favorite games?
I'm crying now.
My favorite games are Pokemon Mystery Dungeon, Explorers of Time, Darkness, and Sky, and Sonic 3 & Knuckles, and Mario Odyssey is, like, way up there. I really like that game.
Fucking Narmy.
God.
I think Pokemon Mystery Dungeon, the second set of games, are my favorite game. Like, that's number one on my list.
Yeah.
Because, like Abe, I associate a little more with memories, so even though they're not, like, the best objectively, they're games that, like, you know, mean a lot to me, and, you know, I like them.
I think, like, PMD was, like, my first 3DS game next to Heart Gold.
DS?
No,
DS. Oh, DS.
Okay.
Also, I forgot to mention Wind Waker.
That's ass.
Okay, listen. not Wind Waker.
I'm angry. And Ocarina of Time. Zelda in general, they really did that. Nintendo, good job.
No, I've never really played any,
20 minutes and got bored.
I've never really played any like Zelda games as a kid.
Feki, what are your favorite games?
I thought I said fuck you. What are your favorite games?
No vulgarity. Feki?
Hey, no. No, no, this is a Christian channel, I'm sorry guys.
I say where the hell I want.
I'm sorry. Okay, my favorite games are Pokemon Heart Gold and Soul Silver, Fire Bloom, the whole franchise actually. And
I forgot
Overwatch
Fire Emblem,
and
oh my God.
Sonic Rings. That's it.
Did you say Sonic and the Secret Rings?
Yes. Okay, listen. So it has bad controls, I swear, but it's a good game.
It has terrible controls. The game is trash.
That was actually my first console Sonic game as a kid.
Is it like an unconditional love, or just like you like it just because?
I like it because of the story, honestly, and like I don't know. I just like it.
Party mode.
Yo, continue. See.
All right, so according to rumors, I'm like just checking online right now. People are saying that a Nintendo Direct is to be expected on January 11th. So I'm super hyped for that.
Oh yeah,
wait, really? That soon? Didn't they just have one in like November?
Yeah, but it's just speculation. But people are thinking that there's going to be a Direct on the 11th, which I would understand. I mean, isn't that what they do usually? And they're probably gonna start off the new year with some hype.
Yeah. Remember this time last year they had the Switch event.
Oh yeah, right, around that time.
Yeah.
So we could probably expect a Metro Prime reveal trailer, like more of it.
Like a real trailer?
Yeah, like real trailer. So like words and numbers, and then like we can probably have like more information about Bayonetta 3, because you know. I kind of want to see more of them legs.
Is that a Switch exclusive, did they say?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. What's a Wii U?
Nani? And probably, Fire Emblem, the new game, I guess.
Oh, yeah, it's Fire Emblem Switch.
Actually,
that's coming out.
You know what? We're sleeping on the Pokemon game. Remember they said there's an RPG being announced in 2018?
Oh, yeah.
They didn't say a year. They just said it was in development.
Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Switch.
Okay, fine. Well, I think they're gonna at least give us a name. And also, this is just like wishful thinking, but I kind of want Pikmin 4.
Yeah, you're lying to yourself. That was in development. That's not out of the question.
Oh, yeah, I heard that they're making like a new Zelda in the background right now.
Yeah. It's in development, but they don't need anything Zelda for the next long amount of time.
Yeah, honestly.
I would like to see the next Zelda be like Majora's Mask, where it uses the same engine as the previous game, but it's like a totally different game.
Oh, so a Switch remaster.
Well, no, not a remaster. It would be like, okay, you know how Majora's Mask played exactly like Ocarina of Time?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
But like, just different place and all that. That's what I would imagine they would do with the next Zelda, because it would save on a lot of resources, because they wouldn't have to make like a new... So it would be kind of like Breath of the Wild 2. They probably wouldn't call it that, but it would feel like Breath of the Wild 2.
So Majora's
in a way that Majora's Mask feels like Ocarina of Time 2.
On the topic of that, I don't know why, but I just like, based off of patterns, they're probably going to remaster a game, an old Zelda game. Yeah, but what is there left to be remastered?
Skyward Sword.
No.
Oh, I was about to say Triforce Heroes, but...
Well, about, actually, like... if they do remaster the handhelds.
Oh, yeah. Well, oh, yeah. Spirit Tracks. Oh.
No.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, Phantom Hourglass.
I mean, I could see them doing the DS games, but I would imagine before then they would do the, like, the Game Boy Color ones.
Oh, yeah, was there... it's like Four Swords, a Four Swords remaster, but that's kind of...
That's called Triforce Heroes. Yeah. No, there was one, ooh, like, on the Game Boy.
We don't talk about that game.
The name is slipping, but it's like a Dreamland place you go to, and it's...
Kirby's Dreamland?
No, I walked right into that joke, though.
Minish Cap.
No, it's on the Game Boy Color. It's like Link...
I freaking love Minish Cap.
Oracle of Ages?
No, or is that a fan that game? Too.
Oracle of Seasons? Link to the Past.
That already has a remaster.
Link's Awakening.
Wait, what'd you say?
Link's Awakening.
Oh.
I could potentially see that get a remaster, but at the same time, that's a 3DS thing that they could do.
Yeah,
Let's talk about the 3DS. Well, do you guys think the 3DS is
dying? Sorry.
They've been saying that. But like,
okay, but I also expect, like, people are saying, like, online that Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon, or no, sorry, what's the, is there a Metroid game coming out on 3DS?
I think
then Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon was like one of the last big development games for the 3DS.
Like how Breath of the Wild was for the Wii U?
Yeah.
We don't talk about the Wii U on this podcast.
Can we talk about Super Smash Bros. 4 and how DLC is not gonna... It's not gonna be existing anymore.
I mean,
I think if they did Smash on the Switch, they would make a deluxe,
you know what,
with all the DLC, and then they would still add DLC.
And they would remove Lucas.
I totally removed Lucas.
Okay, wait. I have a feeling though, if there is a direct, they're probably not gonna announce that many stuff. They're probably gonna talk about the paid service thing, because isn't that coming into play this year?
Yes. That's a 2018 thing.
But it could
I think they
delayed it. I remember reading something about them delaying it, but I don't know if it was true.
It was supposed to come out summer 2017, then fall, and then...
Just delay it forever, please. Right?
I mean, it's not
a bad price. $20 for a year?
I know,
that's a good
way
price.
Better than anything else.
Compared to like PlayStation, $60 a year? Oh my god. I mean, I'd be for like Amazon Prime, $90 a year, but you know, $20 sounds like a deal.
$20,
yeah.
and you get the free virtual console games.
Like actually part of the deal?
It's they very poorly explained it, but yeah, it's kind of like, you know how with Xbox you get like a free game a month.
PlayStation.
Virtual console games, but you don't own them; they just rotate out. It's weird, and I don't think it's monthly.
They rotate once a month. That's kind of gross.
Yeah, I kind of like how PlayStation does it with, like, you get a free game and then you can keep it as long as you pay for a service. But this one, it seems kind of weird. Like, they like switch out. I get it because we like classic games, but it's kind of weird. I'll shut the fuck up.
I also kind of want streaming services to come in. Like, I feel like once they bring
Hulu's
in,
coming.
Yeah, no, who's already there?
Yeah, but
who's there?
Yeah.
Does anyone have a Hulu account?
I do.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm talking about Netflix and YouTube.
I do, because I use Netflix on my Wii U on like a daily basis.
Yeah, I use Netflix on my PlayStation.
What the hell is a Wii U?
My only guess for the delay that no one seems to be talking about is that they would design the Switch versions of Netflix and YouTube to be a little more like the mobile versions, where you can download stuff offline, and then watch it on the go.
Oh, you know what?
That's so much for you.
I mean, if they can do that, that'd be pretty smart. I guess Switch just watching movies and stuff on it.
Now, I think that's worth the wait. Because, like,
some people were also, I don't know, this is just fanboys being picky, but someone said, like, a deluxe dock for the Switch where things could be put into 4K, but I don't need that. I'm fine with how the Switch is now.
I mean, I would, like, really love for the Switch to have, like, you know, like, a little dock station where you can, like, a hard drive into it, so you can, like, store your games onto the hard drive and switch them out when you're about to leave, like, with the Switch. Pretty cool.
Yeah, but I download all my games.
Yeah, I'm about to do that too when I get a Switch. This time, like, your own, like, little base station full of games on the hard drive, so once you dock your, like, your games into it, they'd be able to transfer in between, like, your Switch and the hard drive. And it'd be through USB too, so that'd be sick.
Did they say there was no more ARMS DLC, or was that just a rumor?
Yeah, ARMS is done with updates, which was a short lifespan, but I don't think ARMS had much. Like, it was cool for an hour.
Just like Pokemon.
But,
like Pokemon.
My favorite character is still Sintel. Wait, Twintel.
Of course it is.
Yeah, listen.
My problem with ARMS.
What? Is there a problem with Sintel? Twintel?
No, I love
Twintel. I really don't like games that give you, like, an advantage for motion controls, especially on the Switch, because, like, and this is the problem with Odyssey too, because, like, I don't really mind motion controls, but when I'm playing in handheld mode, like, yeah, not tabletop, but handheld, and I'm, like, laying in bed playing, I can't, like, thrust my screen around, you know?
Yeah. Actually, I'm gonna correct you, Donovan. You had an advantage if you didn't use motion controls.
Really?
Yeah, if you use the Pro Controller, it was way easier to control the arms, so you could pretty much hit every time.
Oh yeah, because, like, move together.
Yep.
Interesting.
He's fucking evil in arms, dude.
All I know is that arms during the test fire, that game was just people grabbing and then throwing and just grab throw.
I mean, there's no problem with grabbing and stuff, but, you know.
Unless you have, like, some huge surprise in it for us, it's probably gonna be, like, a really basic direct that we all end up disappointed.
Yeah, just like usual.
No Smash.
You know what they'll probably talk about? That you would like, Abe? Isn't there more Xenoblade DLC coming?
Yeah, there is. I don't know exactly what it is, even though I'm really into Xenoblade 2. I couldn't find the expansion pack, but that thing's expensive, and I didn't want it. Yeah, I'll do a quick search on what this DLC.
I guarantee they will spend some time on that. Like, no doubt.
I think they're doing something similar to Breath of the Wild.
Yeah, there's an expansion pass. Except this one has more.
Like
a second story. You get helpful item packs, new quest packs, new rare blades, new challenge mode, and then a new story content. So yeah. It looks like it's going to be the same to Breath of the Wild.
Is there, like, support for a whole year?
Let me see. Yeah, fall 2018 is when the new story comes out, and then throughout this year, they're just going to drop, like, the mini stuff that no one really cares about.
So it's just like Breath of the Wild. Okay.
Essentially, yeah.
Do you guys think Mario Odyssey will get DLC?
Hopefully.
Need DLC? Mario Odyssey is fine as it is. I think they should just put it on its high shelf and leave it.
Don't take the loot boxes.
No, I don't think it'll get, like, loot box DLC, but I really think, like, I could imagine them doing, like, a Breath of the Wild style expansion pass where you pay $20 and then they throw in another kingdom.
Hyrule.
Like, during one
they
month.
They add, like, 200 later. More power moons.
Yeah, exactly.
You probably add Hyrule.
But
again.
Would they add 200 more power moons, or would they add new worlds?
Well, if they add worlds, they're gonna add. Oh, you mean, like, moons to the pre-existing?
Yeah.
I could see that, but that would be lame. Honestly,
yeah, I mean, that will all
be I'd have to go back, and I wouldn't know where I've like.
Cause, like, you have, like, redo everything, right?
That's what it would feel like. You'd have to check everywhere again.
Yeah, I don't think Mario Odyssey needs DLC. I think it did really well.
Yeah, but you know,
it's doing well as it is.
It did pretty well, but it didn't really deserve Game of the Year.
Yes, it did.
No, it did not.
I'm just kind of worried. Do you think Nintendo put out all their, like, all their best this year, and the Switch is going to have a slow year for, like, this year?
Oh, no. With like Metroid 4, oh my god, those sales are going to rise.
Yeah, Metroid 4, but is that big one? Is that it?
Crossing.
Yes. Are we going to get Amiibo Festival again? Amiibo Festival Deluxe?
No, I really think Animal Crossing was on the Wii U because of the mobile game. And now that that's out and doing well, Nintendo will see the demand and put it on the Switch. That's my guess.
So, Animal Crossing for the Switch, that'd be cool.
Okay, you can't talk about Switch sales without the Wii U sales. Because it sucked in the beginning because there were no good games for it.
Yeah.
Exactly. But the Switch is the opposite. They threw out all the good games.
Like, it literally, right. Literally outsold the Wii U in 4 years, in like 8 months. Wait, yeah, no, 10 months at this point.
Yeah.
They're like literally touching tips at this point.
Stop.
No.
So.
Bit of an innuendo.
So with the Wii U, right? But when it got Smash Bros. And when it got 3D World, I guess.
Bayonetta 2,
thank you. All those better games, sales started to go up. And if it had those games in the beginning, like if the Wii U opened with something even like 3D World, or there were other good games on it, or Mario Maker, it would have been much better. And when there's already a selling, like when the console's already been sold, then they have a foundation to like put games on. So yeah, I think even if 2018 is a drier year, it'll still be okay. It'll still be okay for sales because people who don't have a Switch yet can still get Splatoon and Mario Odyssey. It's just like the 3DS.
Yeah, and my
opinion, 3DS, they're not going to make games for it, probably. But they'll still probably manufacture them for like, I'd say another year at most.
Yeah, I heard that they'll start making it like by 2019 or 20.
I say 19.
Yeah.
Because if you get a 3DS and you still have money to buy games, you can get a crap ton of Pokemon games. You can get.
I think like three.
There's
like,
other stuff.
Also, like three is like a crap ton. Wait. We have X
and Y. Yeah, remember the full size Pokemon games.
Yeah, we've.
So and two of them are Sun and Moon, because Sun Moon, Ultra Sun Moon.
Oh wait, do they count as one or just like the same?
They're different.
Like Sun Moon and Ultra Sun and Moon.
I don't know. I haven't played them yet. I did order it though.
Well, if you are going to play one of the two, this is just a tip: just play Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon. It's way better.
Yeah, I would imagine.
All right, so
now on the top,
you have a Switch in your room and not a Wii U, so it's automatically a better game.
Okay, right, going back to like the Wii U sales, I think the reason why the Wii U didn't really work out well because of the marketing. I know everyone says that, but like, you know, like this is like more targeted, like it seemed it was targeted to like not the hardcore, just like the casual gamers, like the kids and stuff.
Yeah, because they were trying to do the Wii again.
Yeah, they tried to do like the, you know, the Wii 2, you know, the Wii U.
But they didn't call it the Wii 2, they made it look like an accessory.
Yeah, it was like weird. When I first saw it, I was like, where's the console? Like, it's like a
I honestly thought like it was a little USB stick you put in the back of the Wii and you had the gamepad.
I'm like, whoa, this is cool. Oh wait, yes, it was a whole new console for like $300.
Yeah, which is the same price.
I'm gonna be blind. Yeah,
and then like the Switch is like smaller. Oh, continue.
One of the reasons I think the Wii U didn't do well is just because it was really ugly and unappealing to use. Like you open up and you get this chunky console, and then you're like,
but the gamepad was like hella thick. It was pretty good to hold.
Yeah, but also I really had like, I'm just gonna roast Nintendo for a few seconds. My gamepad charger broke and my gamepad died, and I couldn't play a bunch of games because you need the gamepad to play them. I couldn't play Twilight Princess HD. I couldn't launch mods for Smash. Yeah, I got mods for Smash. Don't sue me.
Oh.
Sorry. Yeah, the gamepad is a little hole. See, I have really big hands, so I love the gamepad. I use it as much as I can. But some of my friends come over, and they use the gamepad, and, like, they have really tiny hands.
What if fuck do you hang out with?
Minions.
is Ang coming over?
All these Despicable Me minions come over and they can't use my gamepad because, you know, their hands are so small. And they have three fingers because they're Despicable Me minions.
Oh my god. Alright, Feki, any thoughts?
Wait, what?
Do you have any thoughts or issues?
Honestly, what are our, what is the ports of Wii games? These, the good games?
Oh yeah, ports of the good Wii, of the good Wii games.
Wii games?
Yeah. Skyward Sword, without motion controls.
Shut the fuck up.
That game! Honestly, for example, like, Fire Emblem Radiant Dawn.
Shut up about Radiant Dawn. This man will not shut up about that damn game.
Okay, listen.
If that gets a remaster, oh my god.
I mean, it shouldn't get remastered. It's like a forgotten game, I swear. And like it gets the old feelings good. Like, the old games are really good. Like, for example, Blazing Blade. I think that should be a remaster as well. Like, I think the game, like one of the game directors said that they're work on Roy's game, like they're trying to remaster the game. I think they should do that, but I think they need to make genealogy of the Holy War first.
Oh, remaster that one, all right.
Yeah, I think they should do that first because, like, I mean, if Shadow of Valentia got a game, then why won't Genealogy of the Holy War get a game? It's a good game, please.
Wait, I think haven't they, like, remastered one, like, the DS games for Fire Emblem?
I think Shadow Dragon is one of them.
Shadow Dragon.
Yeah, Shadow Dragon, like, I forgot the name. It's like, Shadow Dragon is bad, okay? I'm sorry. Shadow Dragon is the worst game in the series. And like Mystery of the I forgot the name of the game. I think there is another remake. Yeah, those are my ideas. I just like Fire Emblem honestly. Right. And yeah, that's it. I guess.
All right. So let's about like the Switch and mature games.
Let's. No, we're not. Hang on. Let's.
Oh my god.
Let's not, because I know exactly where you're going.
Yeah.
We're talking about port. Let's talk about Wii U games going to the Switch.
Ooh.
Do you guys think there's anything left?
Any Wii U games?
Wonderful 101. Holy crap.
Ooh, yikes. 15 minutes.
Oh god.
I've never played that one, but I've heard it's not bad. People wanted the guy in Smash.
Yeah, dude, that'd be amazing. Like, having the 1-4-1-1, or like, and the, like a sequel to the 1-4-1-1. Like the 1-4-2-2.
Wonderful.
Is there any Wii U games that deserve to be ported to the Switch? I'm like trying to ponder.
Yes, Roblox.
Roblox.
Meme Run.
Technically,
Meme
it's
Run.
On the new 3DS.
Meme Run.
Runbow.
Oh god.
Runbow.
I would like
oh.
to see.
Oh, let me go on Switch, because, like, no Joy-Con and stuff.
The only problem is, I don't know if the Switch can do 8 people. On one thing. And that's kind of the fun.
Wait, isn't there 8 people Mario Kart?
Yeah, there's 8 people Mario Kart on, like, yeah. The Switch.
Multiplayer. Yeah, if you have more than one Switch.
Yeah.
But,
more than one
on
Joy-Con.
Screen.
Yeah, because you can only connect 4 Joy-Con or 4 controllers, just like the Wii. Mm-hmm. But what they did with Rumbo is you would have like a Wii remote and then a classic controller hooked up on one player, and then one person would have the classic controller and one person would have the Wii remote. That would be 2 people.
Holy crap.
But the Wii would think it was one person. But Rumbo would know it was 2. So that's how they got around that. I don't think there's a way to do that with the Switch.
Tape your Joy-Con together? or like share a hand?
That's kind of the problem. Like the Wii U has Wii Virtual Console, like Wii games you can buy,
mm-hmm.
because you just use Wii remotes for the Wii U. They're not going to be able to do that on the Switch, because there's no Wii remotes, like, which is a bit of a bummer, because I was hoping when we eventually get Virtual Console, they would do, like, you know, some Wii games. Like, I would like to play Super Mario Galaxy wherever. Or even, like, DS games. That was so cool about the Wii U.
Oh, hey, you like, play DS games on, like, the Wii U. That'd be sick.
Because you had the touch... Yeah, they did that. Because you could have the touch screen on the gamepad and the top screen on the TV.
Really, the Switch has its own, like, capacitive touchscreen, which seemed like godsend, because I used to, like, the screen before, and that thing looked nice.
Like, yeah, but I don't really use the touchscreen, because, like, well, I mean, I'm playing dock most of the time, but even when I'm out and about, you forget that you have a touchscreen, unless you're, like, navigating menus. There's no game that's really about interacting with the screen, because you wouldn't be able to play it in dock mode.
Oh, I just realized that another game that should be, like, remastered or, like, ported to the Switch should be, like, Nintendo World. Oh, wait, I forgot. He's just a gamepad.
Yeah.
He's a gamepad.
They would need some equipment. Maybe two Switches?
Wii Sports. Give us Wii Sports.
I would love Wii Sports on the Switch.
But it's called Wii Sports for a reason.
I don't care. Call it Switch Sports. Call it Wii Sports HD. Or they already did that.
Well, 1-2 Switch.
Oh, yeah.
No. Switch is garbage.
Yeah, 1-2 Switch is bad.
I mean.
Actually, listen, I'm gonna be the one that defends 1-2 Switch. That game saved me at parties.
Yeah, same.
It's a great party game.
I take my Switch to school, and they're like, oh, can we play the game where we shoot people?
That's the only good one on Switch, though. They could have just sold us Quick Fire for $60.
Like, will that be like Red Dead Redemption? Oh
no!
So let me play the game. All right. Now I'll go back to my normal corner.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Oh wait, I had like a thought in my head, but I forgot about it. What was it? Tell you about ports and stuff.
Name Run HD.
Not that.
Please.
I wish though. It was something else. Oh yeah. It was not about ports and stuff. Okay. What kind of is of a port of a PS3 game? I'm thinking about like they should like if they're able to put like GTA 5 on Switch.
Online though.
Online. That might be a separate download. Cause you know how like with Doom on Switch, how they ported it over from like the PS4 version.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can like get the GTA version, you slap it onto the Switch with like you know like the 64 gig, or if they're able to make it, because you know they're having trouble with that 64 gig game card. Even with like the 32 gigs, they're having trouble with that. They like include the card, the whole story mode onto one card, and then they'll put it onto they'll put the multiplayer onto the eShop for like. Like, you know, as an additional download, how they did it for Doom and L.A. Noir. And, like, Resident Evil.
I could see
Resident
that.
Evil cool.
I could see that working.
Hopefully
I kind of thought GTA 5 was... I mean, that's a really old game at this point.
But dude, it's still selling, holy crap.
Yeah. And I mean, if they got Skyrim on Switch, I think anything can go on the Switch.
Yeah,
FIFA on Switch, anything's on Switch.
Doom on Switch, the most beautiful game ever, and like Wolfenstein. Whoa.
I prefer the original Doom.
Me too. But, you know, Doom 2016, dude. My eyes were like melting while I was playing on the PC. Whoa.
Okay, any other predictions for 2018?
I wouldn't say those were predictions. I would say those were wishes that we want.
Wishful 2018 thinking. Guesses.
2018 guesses. This podcast being listened by everyone in the server. I don't know.
Hopefully.
Oh yeah, I should plug the server again. PokePals is a gaming Discord server.
Anime.
Yeah, we have a little bit of anime.
Little
weebs.
But if you want to talk to us directly. And with a bunch of other people, you can join in the links down in the description below. I also have a music server that's kind of like a spin-off of PokePal, so if you happen to be a musician, you can go ahead and talk to us there too. Eli, plug your channel.
My channel? Oh yeah. Fuck, what's your my name was is fuck. Oh my god.
Eli live streams and does weird anime games. I will link his channel in the description too.
My name in the channel is Black Falcon. Because, you know, it's pretty original. The echo with yellow and black, just like arms. I thought that was pretty sexy.
I thought arms was dead.
Go, go fuck yourself. And, like, you know, I do, like, multiple. Like, soon I'll be doing, like, speed art and stuff. So watch out for that. And after this, I probably might stream. Depends on when this is uploaded. Alright, Abe, you should probably, like, plug your shit.
Abe doesn't have anything, I thought.
I have a Twitter.
Abe, what's your Twitter?
So my Twitter is PK underscore Abe, because I'm overly obsessed with Lucas.
That's pretty lame. Alright, fuck you, go.
I hate you.
Okay, my YouTube channel is Roblox Kid. That's it.
Don't listen to him. It's not real.
Okay, don't listen to me. I also have an Instagram. That's it.
What's your Instagram?
It'll be the link in the description.
Yeah. Just do that.
Because, like, if you say it out loud, no one would actually listen to it. If they see a text, they'll see it.
Oh. Yeah, sadly.
Yeah.
We have to write out this entire podcast in text.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, let's do that.
It's called closed captions.
I am not writing the captions for this.
Okay. Say goodbye.
Go fuck you. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Sayonara.
Stop.